as the founding co-chair of the National Policy Alliance and as a delegate for President Barack Obama, I am delighted that the Supreme Court of the United States of America has ruled that the Affordable Health Care Act is constitutional. This is not only a victory for the President of the United States of America, but more importantly, it is a victory for the people of the United States of America, the people, the millions of people, 48 million or more, who do not have health insurance. And many of those are children, children who are not covered. It now means that they will have health care that is affordable and accessible to them. It means that those of us who are in the 99% have an opportunity to know that health care is available for us, not just the 1%. We want to thank the President of the United States of America and his administration for staying the course. I know that there is much debate about whether or not this is good or bad for the doctors and for the hospitals and for the insurance companies. I'm concerned about it, of course, but my major concern, and I'm sure it is the concern of the President of the United States of America, what is in the best interest of our children? What is in the best interest of our elderly? What is in the best interest of our poor people, low-income people in this country? What is in the best interest of those people who are ill? People who are ill with HIV/AIDS, people who are ill with diabetes, people who have heart problems and heart trouble, people who are suffering from infectious diseases throughout the United States of America who cannot get health care. People should not have to decide whether or not they can pay their utilities or go to the doctor. People shouldn't have to make those kinds of decisions. Every American is entitled to affordable and accessible health care in the United States of America. That is a civil right as far as we are concerned. It is a civil right for every American to have affordable and accessible health care available to them. That is one of the privileges of being a citizen of the United States of America. If we've got to pay for it, so be it. We pay for everything else. We should pay for what we need and not for what we just want. We need to have health care, and the cost of it ought to be spread across the board so that we all share the cost proportionately. That's the fair way to approach it. Our president is about the business of doing what is fair, what is right, and what is just. That's why I'm running for mayor of Tuskegee, Alabama, so that I can become the mayor of this great city and be able to work with President Barack Obama, and let's fight for not only health care for the peoples of the United States of America, but let's fight for jobs. Let's fight for education. Let's fight for better social services. Let's fight for a better economy. Let's fight against this high cost of gasoline and gasoline costs. Let's fight against all of these other challenges which is making life in America difficult for the common man, the ordinary man, the 99% of us. That's who we are fighting for in this country, not the middle class. They're going to be fine. The upper class, they're going to be fine. What we have to be concerned about, well, we can't be concerned about Wall Street. Let's be concerned about Main Street in Tuskegee, Alabama, and across this country. So I'm very pleased today. I'm very excited. As you know, the National Policy Alliance, which I have the honor of serving as the founding co-chair, this is the organization that represents more than, first of all, we represent the 9 national black public policy organizations. We also represent more than 3 million black government employees, this organization is the voice of black public policy makers in the United States of America. We had the opportunity to meet with the president not one time, but two times. And in each time, we talked in depth about the Affordable Health Care Act and how important it was. The president said to us, I want you, those of you who represent public policy makers across this country, I want you to support my Affordable Health Care Act. I want you all to advise me on this issue. I want you to get the word out to the people and let them know that I need their support. So he asked for our support, and we gave him our support. We adopted resolutions in support of the Affordable Health Care Act, not only in our 9 national black public policy organizations, which include the Congressional Black Caucus, the National Black Caucus of State Legislators, the National Black Caucus of County Officials, the National Black Caucus of Locally Elected Officials, the National Conference of Black Mayors, the National Black Lawyers and Black Judges, Blacks in Government, which represent 3 million black public policy makers and implementers of public policy, the Joint Center for Political and Economic Studies in Washington, D.C., collectively a group that represents millions of public policy makers. We were not only on board with the president, but we stood with him when many did not. And that's why we're so happy today that the Supreme Court ruled in favor of affordable care being constitutional. This is a great day for America. It is a great day for the people. And yes, it's a great day for Barack Obama. And I'm proud to be his delegate. And I want to become the mayor of Tuskegee, Alabama, so that I can work with the president on behalf of the people of Tuskegee, Alabama, to make sure that we have affordable health care, not only for people in Tuskegee, but for people in Alabama and throughout this nation. Forward.